So when I look at the two riders, male and female, the female has a longer neck in the upper thigh. So this bone here, this whole top is the femur, okay? And the female is cone-shaped. You see how it goes out and then it comes in and then goes down? This part on the female is much longer, the neck of the femur, than on the male. So the male, his knee goes straight down, his femur goes straight down to the knee, to the foot, female comes out, in, down. Furthermore, the muscle on the female, the hamstring is more on the inside, okay? The ladies have, no matter how skinny their thigh is or how strong the thigh is, they have in general a more rounder thigh, where a guy who rides or runs or plays soccer has a more oval thigh. That means right underneath his crotch, there's way more distance than for a female. Now, that makes a massive role, huge role, how these bars, how wide are these bars? Because you're looking at the tree upside down. Here you see an old medieval jousting saddle, and you see how wide these bars are here, okay? So wider the bar, so more weight-bearing surface for the horse. So narrow the bar, so less space between the rider's upper inner thigh. This is in right here in the height of her fingertips. That's where the bars of the tree goes. Now, when you buy a saddle, you don't see that, okay? You don't see the bars. You only know, oh my God, the bars are so wide, my hips hurt. So you fall back, all the pressure goes in the horse, and your foot falls numb or hurts because you're pinching your sciatic nerve. So you don't really see it. So how can you tell what is a male, what's a female saddle? Here you see this dotted thing. This is the seat foam, okay, of an English saddle. Male saddles, at the widest part of the seat foam, are most of the time between, let's say, less than 7 inches from left to right. Female saddles, if a female, you're looking at a seat bone, a seat from the bottom. The outline here, you see the seat bones. Let me show you first before I continue what I'm talking about, so it's easier to visualize where you see the seat bones. Here you see the seat bones from the front. Okay, you see them way out there, and then the pubic branches go down, and then there's a pubic symphysis. Okay, a male saddle has in the front a very high peak because our seat bones are different and our bone structure is different, and we can put our male parts left or right. So a male saddle has a very narrow seaming in the crotch area and a high rooftop that would be pretty much in the front of the seat. Female saddles would have the opposite. If a female sits on the crotch, it hurts, she bleeds, and she has to push herself away from that rooftop. So you can recognize it either in the shape of the pommel or in the back where the seat is the widest. Okay. Number one would be how wide, how pointy that saddle is there underneath your crotch. Number two, how wide the rails are. You can't see that so much. Number one is much easier. But number three is where you sit on top. Okay, so from the side where your seat bones sit, right? So in the rear of the saddle, I still haven't come across. Here we go. Okay, so here you see the pelvis from the side, long tailbone, straight lower back on the male, and the hip sockets fall straight down. Female have more curvature here in the lower back, shorter tailbone, no matter what pelvis you have. There's four different types of female pelvises. All of them have short tailbones. All of them have the hip socket angle forward. And looking from the bottom, so you're looking from the bottom view, you're looking at the male's seat bones, see how much narrow they are versus the female seat bones, how wide they are. But what is very astonishing is that the center of the hip sockets, okay, that's called the pelvis axis, is smack in the middle. That's why all beginner male riders find instantly their balance. All female pelvises, all four different female pelvises. The hip socket is more forward. which means the pelvis axis is more forward and there's more weight in the back. So female riders tend to fall faster in that chair position, especially if you sit in a male saddle for as a woman. So here you see the seat bone distance. So back to the slide I started, where I say when you look at your saddle and you look at from the bottom to see if you have a male or female saddle, the width of the seat foam, okay, must be over 9 inch on the female. If not, your bones hang over the edge and you just hang with your crotch and your underwear line and your pubic branches and your pubic symphysis right on the saddle. So either you're gripping with your thigh or you're pushing yourself back, okay? But you're not sitting on the strong part of your pelvis, okay? You're not sitting on your seat bone. You're sitting on your crotch, pubic symphysis, or what's known as pubic branches, which are very, very vulnerable. So the easiest way to see, measure how wide the seat is. For ladies, minimum 9, if not higher, in inches. And then in the front, see how narrow this is? Okay, that needs to be a minimum of 3 to 4 fingers of a lady's hand. Men, most of the time, just have 1 to 2 finger spacing. So narrow the foam here, so pointier in the crotch area the seat is. We as guys need a pointy crotch, so our male parts go left or right. Ladies, I don't think there's a single lady, heavy, short, no matter what type of female pelvis you have, none of the ladies want to have constant rubbing or chafing in the crotch. So that's how you recognize, by just looking at the top of the seat. If it's a high point in the crotch, stay away. You're looking at a male saddle if you're female. And if the back of the saddle is not wide enough, minimum 9 inches is not long or more, then that's a recognized. So I just explained 2 out of the 9 most important part, the rest.